as mentioned, it's now time in a few minutes for me to sit back and pass over control to the most competent, if not a distinguished gentleman, whom I have admired for a very long time, for his strength of character and his good speaking ability. He's been a member since 1997. Distinguished Toastmaster Peace at 11. Held the post of club president in 2001 and 2002. Meek Housemaid's greatest achievement for the club is netting 2,000 ringgit by conducting a speech craft for the audience is that it is a course that the Diotama runs, basically a crash course over the weekend of all Toastmaster skills. But anyhow, over the years though, the Jewish Toastmaster Jesse Malingham continues to contribute his time and effort and experience with the Diotama, doing advice, conducting workshops, and just being here. He's a man of a wealth of experience, and he enjoys glancing at the lovely purple shade of the morning glory. Now hand control over to our distinguished Toastmaster, our morning glory, to carry on with the evaluation session.
Pay back the gratitude to our parents. That's a take-home message in the speech. And for the points of improvement, I think maybe I'm old or maybe I didn't clean my ear thoroughly. I wish that maybe you can perhaps raise up your voice. You know, I find that I have a hard time sitting over there just trying to catch every single word coming out from the stage. And as a salesperson, a lot of times you're not given a microphone to deliver your presentation. So the volume that you have is very critical when you try to present something to the directors or even to the doctors. Okay? And nevertheless, I do enjoy your speech and I look forward to your next speech. Thank you very much.
So for Jermaine Liu, I just want a quick impression I had. You were very, what shall I say, poised and confident. That's the impression I had of you. I didn't know where you were going to go, poised and confident. And I must concur with your evaluator, Jermaine. I also had a senior citizen moment. I was trained to listen to you, and you were just less than 10 feet away from me. I really would recommend that you increase the volume. Perhaps I could help you on that too. Moving along, next is a speaker, the ice mystery lady number 2, Marilyn Monroe, or sorry, Marilyn Monroe. It's an association of ideas. To call upon the evaluator speech number 2, can I call upon Marilyn's evaluator, competent communicator, Jason Chu. Everybody has different opinions, and you may even come across the same speech, one person loves it, somebody else is, somebody else gets it. So speakers take it in stride, take it with a grain of salt, but do keep an open mind. Couple of comments for Marilyn. One thing I noticed, one of our assets actually today I didn't see very much is a smile. She's got a wonderful smile, ladies and gentlemen. Today it is not so much in evidence, I thought. You should make, capitalize on that as much as possible. Not to the extent that you're grinning like a mad woman, but do use it. I only saw it at the end part today. The other point of improvement I really must comment, because I'm not sure the others have noticed, it was very noticeable to me, you were actually swaying very gently from side to side. Very noticeable because you got lines behind you. Not a major thing, but you do need to understand as you move forward, these things are completely unconscious, you should be aware, because people do notice these things. And later, as you move higher and higher, these things can be detected. Just be aware of that. It's not to say that you've got to fix it, you just be aware that it is distracting to me. Just be aware. It's a very minor point. The rest, I think your evaluator did a very thorough job already. Congratulations. Next, can I go upon the third mystery speaker, Dr. Go Shin Yi. To evaluate her, can I call upon her evaluator, advanced communicator Silver, competent leader, Alan Kapp.
I can't change the direction of the wind, but I can adjust my sails to always reach my destination. That is the word I want to leave with you today, Dr. Go Shin Yi. You cannot change the direction of the wind for this evening, past is in past, but you sure can adjust your sails to reach your destination. And your destination this evening was to deliver a touching story. Not just a story, but to rouse our emotions and connect with us on an individual level. I say you're a fighter. I was sitting down there, and when you hit the mental block, I was thinking, man, what's she gonna do? I saw you standing straight. Your thumbs were ready. I assume you were stressed, but you look like you're ready to hit someone. You're gritting your teeth. But I tell you, you are a fighter. Common lady out here would have just sheepishly went back, but you did not. So cling on to that. It happens to even the best of speakers, no matter the techniques, there will be the day that you are stumped. My two hands and challenge to you and to all of us is make use of this laboratory environment. This is the best of the test of sales you're gonna have. So I submit back to you to rethink and reevaluate your speech today. Whether you're able to rouse emotions, whether you felt really good connecting us on all these levels. There were strengths there, but I think with your intellect, and I think the lady was correct, you are an intelligent person, and I know you. Give it a good thought and see how can I take advantage of this fantastic scenario to come back with a difference. Choose not just to finish off a speech, but choose to always adjust your sails to reach your destination. So Dr. Go Shin Yi, do not treat this as defeat. All of us here, the time that you are stumped, never treat it as defeat. Treat it as another opportunity that you have, whether in this part, whether to redo, to bring to life the glorious image of your grandmother in your heart. I can detect your love and admiration for her. Make use of this platform to celebrate her life, to share with us why she's so special in her life. Dr. Go, I know if you put your heart to it, you can do it. So I submit to you, adjust yourselves to reach your destination. Back to you.
Whether we can, how perfect our memory is. So we can always use aids. nothing wrong with putting notes down there, the side there, your stump, just refer to it, continue. You're not being judged on how perfect your memory is. You're being judged on how well you're delivering what you want to say. So it's not memory test, not just for Shini, for anybody for that matter. Use the aids. Use it discreetly, but that's the issue. You're not here to test your memory. Second point for Shini, personally, I wanted to comment to you. You sometimes when you speak, you sound as if you're out of breath. Today, even though you first, you're stumped in your speech, you never, or you're smooth all the way. I want to congratulate you on that. You did well. Good job. Give the evaluate Bingy as a, I want to call this an introducer of the host for the evening. Can I call upon her evaluator, advanced communicator bronze, advanced the silver, Henry Fulian?
Thank you, dear evaluator, geez, you know, distinguished Toastmaster. It's my pleasure to evaluate the Toastmaster evening in Bingy. Now, for the benefit of guests and first timers, may be wondering, the lady never gave a speech, and now I will be reading her. Now, when you go to the advanced manual, what an advanced manual is on specialty speeches. And project number 5, the role of evaluate is to evaluate the Toastmaster evening from the beginning, from how you conduct meeting from the start to its conclusion. That is the duty of the evaluator, to see how he MC the meeting. So there's no need for her to speak, but I will evaluate her on how she conducted the meeting. Of course, well, Lim Beng Yi is a seasoned speaker, veteran, I would say, a compare extraordinaire. Very hard to find any witnesses in the conduct of the meeting. She met the director of the speech. Let me read you some of it. Did the Toastmaster make reference to the program and involve the audience? Definitely. To her, the program is like a roadmap to tell her where to start, where she's going, what milestone has achieved, and to the final destination. And she has followed it to the letter, I must say. It was well sequenced and conducted smoothly. Did the Toastmaster refer to other speakers and the topics all the time? When he introduced all speakers, he mentioned them and what he wouldn't speak about, but in the end, he didn't condemn. It was his interest, definitely. Every time she introduced speakers, she also asked for applause. Only one thing lacking is when she asked for applause, she doesn't clap herself. She never didn't clap. When you ask for applause, clap yourself too, lead the way, and then clap, then the others will follow naturally. And his question mentioned the qualification of all the speakers. They are qualified in CDM, CL, DTM. That was read out to all, for all the speakers. Well done. Speaker's background also read, produced briefly. Objective. Did the Toastmaster wait for other speakers to arrive at the lectern before sitting down? What's the observation? Definitely, isn't it? All the speakers came up. Then, after that, no need to sit down. Very respectful to the speakers. Only thing, there's one thing about the program. You all notice in the dress code, gentleman office attire. Before that, he sent us an email. Dare you to wear flowery attire. But I suppose we're all creatures of habit. We're so used to wearing strong suit and necktie and ladies dress smartly. I don't see anyone wearing flowery shoes today. I don't know what happened. I want to grab my, I forgot last name. So maybe this one we should put flowery attire to follow your desire to ask the audience to wear flowery attire. But here, in fact, to say something, gentleman office. Thank you very much.